My dear young friends, in the last class, we have discussed the various components of air pollution. Today, we are going to study the other major types of pollution in the environment. Various other pollutions are, one is water pollution, second is sound pollution, third is radiation pollution. Water pollution can be defined as physical, chemical, biological changes in water quality that adversely affect living organisms is called by the term water pollution. It comprises infectious agents, oxygen demanding wastes, inorganic pollutants, sediments, thermal pollution. The infectious agents comprises the waterborne disease causing organisms such as typhoid, cholera, bacteria, amoebic dysentery, polio, infectious hepatitis and guinea worm. All these are due to the lack of proper sanitation. The table display the major human disease transmitted by polluted water comprising cholera, dysentery, enteritis, typhoid, infectious hepatitis, poliomyelitis, cryptosporidiosis, amoebic dysentery, schistosomiasis, caused by a variety of infectious agents belonging to bacteria, virus, protozoa, fungi. The second major component is eutrophication. It is a natural process by which the water comprising lakes and rivers become extensively enriched with nutrients such as nitrogen and phosphorus. Depends upon the amount of these components, the water body can be categorized into three major types. One is oligotrophic, comparatively poor in nutrients. Second one is mesotrophic, slightly richer in nutrients. Third one is eutrophic, rich in nutrients. Human activities often enhance the rate of change due to the activities such as farming, forestry, road building, industry, waste treatment that cause nutrients to enter into water courses. This nutrient enrichment often results in a population explosion of cyanobacteria or the blue-green algae, similarly other aquatic organisms. In the past 40 years, there is comparatively reduction is accounted in the toxic discharges of phosphorus from point resources. Meanwhile, there is largely uncontrolled sewage inputs of nitrogen, non-point source of nitrogen phosphorus. The consequences are, one is creating a dead zone. Second is abundance of harmful algal blooms. Third one is the coral death. Oxygen demanding wastes. Oxygen dissolved in water is an indicator of water quality, commonly called dissolved oxygen. 6 parts per million of oxygen or more normally support aquatic life. Usually, the quality of the water is checked by an index or a marker known by the term BOD, biological oxygen demand, which measures the amount of dissolved oxygen consumed by the aquatic microorganism. It comprises sewage, paper pulp or food waste can cause an oxygen sag where only a few fish can survive. In the lower diagram, there are different zones are pointed out and the organism prevailing there: clear zone, decomposition zone, septic zone, recovery zone, clean zone. In each zone, the BOD is variable. Based upon the BOD, the organism available also show variation. BVOD is usually related with the event called eutrophication, rapid succession in a body of water because of an increase in biological productivity. Meanwhile, in oligotrophic lakes and rivers have clean water with a low biological productivity. In the lower diagram, you can see one is a oligotrophic lake which comprises low nutrient, good light penetration, high dissolved oxygen, deep waters, low algal bloom, small mouth, lake trout, pike, whitefish. Meanwhile, in the eutrophified lake or the water body comprising high nutrient levels, poor light penetration, low dissolved oxygen, shallow waters, high algal growth. Similarly, it comprises certain fish like catfish. So here the diagram representing one of the common algal component commonly occurring in eutrophified lake, namely microcystis, a toxic blue-green algae. Usually, this phenomenon is commonly called by the term green slime, which is highly dangerous for other aquatic organisms, especially fishes. The third major impact of eutrophication is coral reef overgrowth, which comprises nutrients stimulate algae that cover the coral mass. Secondly, loss of habitats and biodiversity. Thirdly, loss of economic benefits. So, it clearly indicates that eutrophication in lakes or the water body directly or indirectly affecting the coral reef. What are the solutions for eutrophication? The number one is that usage of fertilizer should be limited and apply in appropriate periods or time. Second is control runoff and soil erosion. And third is start compost pile and recycle yard waste properly. Fourth one is conserve the water and energy. The last one is cultivate plants and other deep-rooted plants to minimize the level of eutrophication. The third important water pollutants are inorganic pollutants, which are mainly comprising the heavy metals like mercury, lead, tin, cadmium, selenium, arsenic. All these are released by the activities of human being. Metals, mercury poisoning from coal, incineration, which cause damage to the nervous system, mental retardation, cerebral palsy, development delays, kidney disorders. So, the disease was coined by the term Minamita disease because of the victims of Minamita Bay by eating fish which containing mercury. The second major heavy metal is lead poisoning, again from incineration, pipes, solder, previously in gasoline. This causes brain damage, commonly called plumbosis. Secondly, hearing loss. Third is learning disabilities. Usually, Mad Hatter is a common terminology employed to denote the mercury damage caused by those people working in the hat industry. Mercury, once used extensively in the hat making process, causing a brain illness in many hatters. Mercury is still a major water pollutant around Danbury Cone, 19th century, hat making capital of the world. The third one is arsenic, usually released from mining or drainage of desert soils. This causes anemia, cancer, and even death. The other inorganic pollutants are sodium chloride, which leads to salinization. And the next one is acids, sulfur and nitrogen compounds from coal. This causes change of pH, which directly affecting the acidity of the water. Similarly, it also leaches aluminium. In the diagram, on the one side, I have represented the major cause caused by arsenic pollutant. On the right hand side, the lead poisoning. Arsenic poison leading to neuro damage or nerve damage. Similarly, skin damage, commonly called hyperkeratosis, higher pigmentation of skin, especially in the toe region, commonly called by the term black foot disease. At acute stage, it affecting lungs, bladder, kidney, ends in liver cancer. It also affecting circulatory problems in skin. In the case of lead poisoning, high level of lead leading to mental retardation, coma stage, convulsions, and even deaths. Whereas, low level of lead leading to reducing your IQ, impaired growth, reading and learning disabilities, hearing loss, and a range of other health and behavioral effects. So, both cadmium, lead, arsenic leading to poisoning. The other pollutants comprising POP, commonly called persistent organic pollutants. They are chemical substances that persist in the environment, bioaccumulate through the food web, and pose a risk of causing adverse effects to human health and also to the environment. There are 12 elements are commonly included under the category known by the term dirty dozens, including PCB, aldrin, chlorodyne, DDT, dieldrin, endrin, hepatochlor, hexachlorobenzene, myrex, polychlorinated dibenzodioxin, polychlorinated dibenzofurans, and toxophene. The first one is dioxin. So, it is a chlorinated byproduct, highly stable and very slow to degrade. It is generated from burning of wood, coal, oil, household trash, and chlorine bleaching of pulp and paper. It accumulates in fat of animals, leading to biomagnification or biological amplification. It causes cancer, and also it will weaken your immune system. PCB, that is polychlorinated biphenyls, non-inflammable, not dissolved in water, high boiling points, does not conduct electricity, so used for transformers and capacitors. More than 1 billion pounds of PCB have been made, accumulate in fats of animal. Just like the previous case, it also lead to biomagnification. The impacts are cancer, hormonal and reproductive disruptions, decrease cognitive abilities by affecting dopamine content. The most disaster organic pollutant is DDT, dichloro, diphenyl, trichloro, ethane. Is an insecticide, stable and slow to degrade. Paul Muller won the Nobel Prize in 1948 for developing this organic pollutant. Benefits: it control spread of malaria and providing crop protection. The table here displaying annual global production and use of DDT in various countries. So, India stands second in the use of DDT following China. The problem concerned with the DDT. DDT is not easily metabolized. So, like the previous organic pollutants, it also accumulates in the body, leading to biomagnification. Usually, DDT accumulation was reported mostly in higher tropic levels. For example, whatever the DDT applied to the plants are leached into the water body, where it enter into algal body. From there, it migrating are taken by small fishes. From the small fishes, it moves to larger fishes. From there, it was fed by birds, where it is accumulating. The diagram cleanly representing the impact of DDT. So, it was available in water in very minute part per million. So, from there to the bird reaching to the level of 124 part per million. So, this directly affecting the bird population by affecting the calcium content of the shell. So, here you can see the level of DDT leading to mortality in birds. Calcium level is decreased as a consequence of DDT impacts. Again, estrogen mimic invertebrates, feminizes males, lowers sperm count, alters behavior. Similarly, in humans, it decreases mental function, male infertility, and again ends in cancer. The organic pollutant DDT leading to evolution of resistant non-target species and also creating new pests. So, here the graph indicating that after the usage of DDT, the formation of new resistant insects are regularly increasing in the earth. The next water pollutant is sediments. Sediments are erosion and runoff from soil, which normally fills the lakes, obstructing shipping channels, clog hydroelectric turbines, purification more costly. Two diagrams representing the level of sediments. In the left hand side, you can see high level of sediments, where most of the organisms are buried beneath the sediments. Whereas in the second diagram, the level of sediment was comparatively low. So, the organisms are highly exposed. So, that denoting the impact of sediments on living biota. The next one is thermal pollution, is the use of water as a coolant by power plants and most of the industries. When water is used as a coolant, it is returned to the natural environment at a higher temperature. A change in temperature decreases oxygen supply and also affecting the ecosystem composition. So, this normally affecting the aquatic biota. Thermal pollution leading to an increase in temperature. It causes the thermal shock, greater vulnerability to toxic pollutants. In the chart here, it causes health problem. Similarly, it causes ecosystem disruptions. So, basically, thermal pollution affecting normal aquatic organism, both plants, animals and microorganisms. Specific source of groundwater pollution comprising rate of breakdown is extremely slow in groundwater. Industrial waste into aquifer recharge zone, surface runoff into abandoned wells, industry, agriculture, home, leaking underground storage tanks of gas stations, leaking septic tank into recharge area, injection wells for secondary recovery. These are the specific sources of groundwater pollution. Pollution discharge is classified into point source and non-point source. Point source representing the discharge of pollutant from a single point. Meanwhile, the non-point source representing discharge of pollutant in a scattered manner, not having a specific location. Major agriculture pollutants are atrazine, metachlor, alachlor, and go on to the level called cymosine. So, each compound have got varied level in the nature. So, there are a lot of legislation to minimize the water pollution. One is the Clean Water Act implemented in 1972. Similarly, safe drinking water also to regulate water quality in commercial and municipal system in 1974. So, there was an experiment carried in America in a largest estuary Chesapeake Bay, where they have reducing nutrient loading, banning phosphate detergents, restoring seagrass and wetlands, upgrading wastewater treatment plants. So by this treatment, they have improved the water quality. So that show that we can also able to improve the water quality by such activities. So what are the way in which we can improve the water quality? By treatments. It comprising three major components. One is primary treatments, where we are removing physically the solid wastes. Second is the secondary treatments, including aeration tank, biodegradation. And third is tertiary treatment, remove phosphates, nitrates, bioremediation, use of organism to remove water pollutants. So if we can employ the polluted water body to these components, we can improve the quality of the water. Here in the diagram, you can see the primary sedimentation tank, where we are separating the solid waste. So the second one is the secondary sedimentation tank, where we are removing biodegrading the waste. And third one is the tertiary treatment, where we are removing completely the phosphate and nitrates. Similarly, here also the diagram representing the same, the primary tank, secondary tank, and third one is the tertiary treatment. So by this treatment, we can remove all the solid and also the pollutant from the water sources. So what is the impact of these treatments? Primary, secondary, tertiary, followed by chlorination treatments. So the phosphorus content can be removed in the primary, secondary, to an extent the tertiary. Nitrogen, very similar to the phosphorus. Virus can be removed. Dissolved organics can be removed, even at the primary level. Pathogenic bacteria can be removed. Similarly, the sewage solids. So water treatment can improve the quality of the water. The second major pollutant is noise pollution. So here the diagram, you can see the impact of sound on the human being. So there is two terms commonly we are employing. One is the noise and second one is called sound. Even though they are not dissimilar, there is minute difference between them. The word noise comes from the Latin word noxia, meaning injury or hurt. Noise is an unwanted, unpleasant and annoying sound caused by vibration of the matter. Vibration imprints on the ear drums of a human or animal and set up a nervous disturbance which we call sound. When the effects of sound are undesirable, that it may be termed as noise. So that means unpleasant sound is commonly called by the term noise. So as I said earlier, there is no physical separation between sound and noise. So noise normally creating stress. Sound never create any stress. Usually we measure the sound in terms of decibel. So here I have narrated the sound in terms of decibel in breathing, whisper and other components. During breathing, the sound is only 10 decibel. Again during whisper, it became 20 decibel. In a quiet office, the sound is reaching to the level of 40 dB. In normal conversation, it became 60 decibel. When it goes beyond 80 decibel, it creating human problems. Noise pollution can be broadly classified into two major types, called by the term community noise or environmental noise. Second one is occupational noise, or commonly called industrial noise. For example, aircraft noise, roadway noise, water noise pollution. So they are coming under the category community noise. Community noise, also called environmental noise, residential noise or domestic noise, is defined as a noise emitted from all sources except from industries. The source of noise pollutions are road traffic noise, aircraft, noise from railroads, construction noise, noise in building, noise from consumer products, loudspeaker, public addressing system, firecrackers. So these are the common sources of noise pollutions. So the second one is industrial. Industrial machinery and processes can lead to the creation of unpleasant noise. Road traffic noise. In the city, the main source of traffic noise are the motors, which are creating unpleasant sounds. Aircraft noise. So nowadays, sound was also created from aircrafts. Again, the noise from railroads, so which is even reaching to the level of above 90 decibel. Again, construction from buildings, so which also creating unpleasant noise. Apart from dwellers are often annoyed by noise in their homes, especially when the building is not well designed and constructed. In this case, internal building noise from plumbing, boilers, generators, air conditioners and fans can be audible and annoying. Again, noise can also create from household equipments such as vacuum cleaners, mixers, kitchen appliances, etc. Loudspeakers can create a lot of noise. Again, firecrackers during festival period can also cause annoying sounds. So, what are the major problems caused by the noise pollution? It includes hearing impairment, the major disaster. It decreases the efficiency of a man. Lack of concentration. Abortion is also caused. Dilation of pupil. Mental illness. It can also lead to heart attack. Again, it ends in digestive problems. Temporary or permanent deafness, aggressive behavior, reducing the growth of vegetation, similarly the quality of the crop, affecting the animals, affecting on property, sleep interference, interference in speech. So, out of the above, the major impairment come to hearing capacity. Higher sound above 80 decibel can disrupt the eardrum, so which leads to hearing impairments. Noise can adversely affect performance, for example, reading, attentiveness, problem in solving and memory power. It also lead to lack of concentration. In big cities, most of the offices are on the main road. The noise of the traffic or the loudspeakers or the different type of horns divert the attention of the people working in the offices. Often, noise can lead to fatigue. In women, it lead to abortion. Because sound, sudden noise cause abortion in female. Noise pollution can cause dilation of pupil of the eye. It lead to lack of peace of mind. That means some sort of mental illness affecting anxiety, nervousness, nausea, headache, emotional instability, sexual impotence, change in mood, increase in social conflicts, neurosis, hysteria and psychosis. It also change your heartbeats, increasing your cholesterol level, constriction in blood vessels, creating blood pressure, trigger both endocrine and nervous system that affect the cardiovascular system. High level of stress hormones such as cortisol, adrenaline, noradrenaline can lead to hypertension, stroke, heart failure and immune problems. Noise pollution can cause digestive spasms and stomach disorders. Similarly, it can lead to aggressive behavior in human being. Effect on vegetation. Usually, noise pollution can reduce the quality of the crop. Here you can see the plant subjected to different noise condition. In the first case, the plant was very healthy with plenty of foliage. As and when we are increasing the sound continuously, the leaves are completely fallen down, that is leading to defoliation, that narrating the impact of noise on plants. Similarly, noise pollution is affecting both terrestrial and aquatic animals. Effect on beached whale. One of the best known damage caused by noise pollution is the death of certain species of beached whales brought on or by the loud sound of military sonars. So, that was an experiment carried by the people. Noise pollution can affect your property, especially the buildings, bridges and monuments. Similarly, it will interfere your sleep. A jerking will occur and you will be awaking during the sleep because of change in the level of cortisol, adrenaline and noradrenaline. Noise more than 50 decibel can be very difficult to hear and interpret and cause problems such as partial deafness. Some effects may lead to increased accidents, disruption of communication in the classroom and impaired academic performance. So, what are the ways in which we can mitigate the noise? Noise mitigation is a set of strategies to reduce noise pollution. Use of horns can be reduced by devices such as silencers. Similarly, noise producing industries should be placed or inhabited in areas remote from thick human population. Proper law amendments to reduce the loudspeaker usage between 10 p.m. to 6 a.m. Construction of soundproof room. Similarly, growing green plants or trees along the roadside, which tremendously reducing noise by absorbing the sound. So, here one of the major remedy is by cultivating as many plants as possible. This will impact the reduction in the sound waves. Similar to automobiles, lubrication of the machinery and servicing should be done to minimize noise generation. Soundproof doors and windows can be installed to block unwanted noise from outside. A regulation should be imposed to restrict the use of playing loudspeakers in crowd areas and public places. Factories and industries should be located far away from residential zones. Community development or urban management should be done with a long-term planning, along with an aim to reduce noise pollution. Social awareness programs should be taken up to educate the public about the causes and the effects of noise pollution. The last pollution is radiation pollution. So, here I have shown a figure. So, you might have known the figure. At 1:23 a.m. on 26th April 1986, a human error and poor safety standards caused a terrible explosion. It was a nuclear accident at Chernobyl power station that shook the whole world. the accident in Chernobyl has influenced the ecological situation in Leningrad region. This accident caused high level of land pollution. Radioactive elements from soil get into plants, then into the human organisms. A major tragedy accounted in Leningrad region. Radionuclides are compounds which are emitting radiation such as alpha rays, beta rays, gamma rays. Alpha particle can be blocked by a piece of paper or the human skin, so not leading to much damage. Beta particles can penetrate through skin, while can be blocked by some pieces of glass and metals. Gamma rays can penetrate easily to human skin and damage cells on its way through reaching far, and can only be blocked by very thick, strong, massive piece of concrete. So the disaster in radiation are caused by gamma rays. So what are the sources from which the rays are released? One is nuclear power plants, second is nuclear weapon, third is transportation, fourth is disposal of nuclear waste, and fifth one is uranium mining. Natural, unstable disintegrates spontaneously, emitting both particles and energy. Artificial bomb formed by atoms with their kernels decay causing radiation. For example, by heating an uranium nucleus with a neutron core will be split into several fragments, producing other neutrons with high energy release, strongly accelerates this energy by products reaction, again causing another split. This is used in nuclear fission reactors, nuclear power, where the reaction is always controlled by a moderator who absorbs too fast the neutrons, liberating the nuclear energy, which is captured, evacuated, transformed into electricity. So during this event, there are possibility for radiations. Natural source of radioactive radiation, cosmic radiations containing protons, neutrons and mesons, radioactive minerals in soil, radium emanation from rocks. Similarly, source of artificial radioactivity, nuclear bomb, nuclear experiments, aerospace, radioactive waste, medical exposures such as X-rays, X-ray treatments, irradiation with radioactive cobalt, nuclear accidents. The effects of radioactive pollution on the human body includes discoloration, lesions, radiodermatitis. Production of nuclear weapons, one of the major causes for radiation. Radioactive materials used in this production have high health risk, release a small amount of pollution comparatively. Decommissioning of nuclear weapons. The decommissioning of nuclear weapons cause slightly more radioactive pollution than the production. However, the waste alpha particle is still of low risk and not dangerous unless ingested. Mining of radioactive ore such as uranium, phosphate, etc. Mining this involves crushing and processing of the radioactive ores, and this generate radioactive waste which emit alpha particles. This waste is of low risk unless ingested. Coal ash, another major reason leading to radiation. Some coal contains more radioactive material than usual and is often referred as dirty coal. When this is burned, the ash becomes more radioactive, as radioactive particles do not burn well. This level of radioactivity is less than in phosphate rocks. However, due to small amounts being released into the atmosphere and its ability to be inhaled, this ash is significantly more dangerous. Medical waste, a number of radioactive isotopes are used in medicine, either for treatment or for diagnosis. This also leads to problems. Nuclear power plants currently standard produce little radioactive pollution due to safety precautions. Accidents such as what occurred in Chernobyl, similarly after earthquake, a tidal wave in Japan, Germany, leading to radiations. What are the ways in which we can control or regulating radiation from these sources? One is geological disposal. This is effectively the burying of radioactive material. Large geological formations are located and tunnels as deep as 1000 meter underground that are drilled. Transmutation, another way. Transmutation of radioactive waste is the process of consuming this radioactive waste, turning into less harmful products, commonly called transmutation. Reuse of radioactive waste. Some radioactive isotopes such as strontium-90, cesium-137 are able to be extracted for use in other industries such as food irradiation. Space disposal. Space disposal is not currently used to reduce radioactive pollution due to the potential problems which could occur when attempting to carry out the procedure. For example, a rocket used to launch the waste fails, then huge amount of radioactive material would be released into the atmosphere, causing significant health risk to people within thousands of miles of the launch. So nowadays, we are not recommending space disposal. Common radiation emitting compounds hazardous to human being are tobacco, which release a radioactive compound called polonium-210. Similarly, ophthalmic glass, television, luminous watches and dials release tritium. Airport X-ray systems, smoke detectors containing americium, fluorescent lamp, lantern mantles contain thorium. Similarly, potassium-40, cobalt-60, strontium-90 are also equally dangerous. Hope that now we can move into the question session. The first question: the direct threat of climate change in marine habitat is the option A, melting glaciers; option B, spread of tropical diseases; option C, decreased salinity of seawater; option D, rising of sea levels; option E, ozone depletion. The correct answer is rising of sea level. The climate change leading to melting of glaciers, which ends in rising the sea level. Question number 2. Which type of electricity generating power plant releases radioactive materials as well as toxic metals such as lead, arsenic under normal operating conditions? The options are A, nuclear; B, hydroelectric; C, solar; D, coal burning; E, geothermal. The correct answer is coal burning. Coal-fired power plants release includes acid gas such as hydrogen chloride, hydrogen fluoride, benzene, toluene and other components, dioxin and furans, formaldehyde, lead, arsenic and other metals mercury, polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbons, radioactive materials like radium and uranium. So these are the possibilities released from coal burning. Question number 3, biochemical oxygen demand or biological oxygen demand is an important measure of option A, the oxygen using potential of water and wastewaters, B, a measure of biological activity of water and wastewater, C, oxygen content of water and wastewater, D, an organism's natural level of oxygen requirement to decompose organic pollutants. BOD is defined as an amount of oxygen required to oxidize organic pollutants in water. So the correct answer is option D, an organism's natural level of oxygen requirement to decompose the organic pollutants. Question number 4, thermal pollution raises the solubility of oxygen in water. Option A, respiratory rates of aquatic organisms. Option B, nurtures spawning fish. Option C, can kill organisms adapted to particular temperature range by thermal shock. Option D, leads to algal bloom. The correct answer is option C. Thermal pollution can lead to killing of organisms adapted to a particular temperature range because of thermal shock. So the correct answer is option C. Question number 5, a difficulty level of question. So there are two columns are given. You have to match the column 1 with the column 2. The column 1 comprising municipal sewage treatment of physical separation of solids. Second one is first accidental leakage of radioactive pollutants. Third one, sewage treatment of removal of phosphate or nitrates. Fourth one, friends of Arcata marsh. Column 2, A, 3-mile island, B, primary treatments, C, Arcata at California, D, secondary treatments. You can go through the codes and find out the correct code for matching column 1 with column 2. The correct option is option A. Municipal sewage treatment of physical separation of solids is commonly called primary treatments. First, accident leakage of radioactive pollutants, 3-mile island. Sewage treatment of removal of phosphate or nitrates, secondary treatments. Friends of the Arcata marsh, Arcata at California. So the correct option is option A. Question number 6. Chlorine is often added to wastewater for disinfection before effluent discharge. A potential problem with this procedure is option A, toxic chlorinated hydrocarbon may be formed. B, chlorine gas is poisonous and may threaten nearby homes. C, the chlorine promotes cultural eutrophication. D, chlorine is a non-renewable resource and may soon be depleted. E, chlorine contributes to depletion of the ozone layer. The correct answer is option A. Toxic chlorinated hydrocarbons may be formed as and when we are treating water with chlorine. So the option is A. Toxic chlorinated hydrocarbon may be formed. Seventh question. Possible health effects of noise pollution include option A. Vision imbalance. B. Hypertension. C. Tinnitus. D. Mutation. Option E. Both B and C. The correct answer is option both B and C. The word tinnitus meaning ringing noise. So, another cause caused by the impact of sound pollution, we got a ringing noise in the ear. So, the answer is both B, sound pollution leading to hypertension as well as tinnitus. Question number 8. Which of the following statements is false? A. Biomagnification is due to biodegradable wastes. B. Acid deposition represents a more serious hazard to lake than rivers. C. Heavy metals like fluoride leads to muscular dysentery and fluorosis. D. Human activities can accelerate the eutrophication process. E. Fallout represent a more serious hazard to lakes than rivers. The correct option is option A. Biomagnification is due to biodegradable waste. It's a wrong statement. Biomagnification is due to accumulation of non-biodegradable waste. The ninth one, again matching the following. So, you can match the compartment A with the compartment B. The first compartment comprising black food disease. Second one is noise permissible in residential zone during day and night time. Third one is plumbosis. Fourth one is noise permissible in silent zone during day and night time. The second compartment comprising A. Lead, B. Arsenic, C. 50 at a day and 40 at night. Option D. 55 at day and 45 at night. E. 40 at day and 35 at night. The combination of codes are given below. A, B, C, D and E. The correct answer is option A. Black food disease is caused by arsenic because of hyperpigmentation. Noise permissible in residential zone during day and night time are 55 during the daytime and night it becomes 45. Plumbosis, a brain damage caused by lead. Noise permissible in silent zone during day and night time are 50 at day and 40 at night. The last question is one of the easiest question. Gas leaked in Bhopal tragedy is methyl isocyanate, potassium isothiocyanate, ethyl isocyanate, sodium isothiocyanate. The correct answer is option A, methyl isocyanate. So, December 2 and 3, 1984, at the Union Carbide India Limited pesticide plant in Bhopal, Madhya Pradesh, released the compound MIC or methyl isocyanate. Over 500,000 people were exposed to this tragedy. So the correct answer is methyl isocyanates. Thank you.